Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
In this video, I will model suspension bridge by taking some equivalence facts and figures of Forth Road Bridge, Scotland. I am not using proper design code for bridge design or loads because main idea of this video is how we can model suspension bridge with its main cable and hanger ropes so that load is transferred accurately from deck to hanger ropes then proceed from main cables to tower. Main span of bridge is 1006 meters supported between two towers. Side span is 408 meters from both sides of tower to anchorage. Deck width of bridge is 33 meters. Deck level is 47 meters from lowest tower point to deck surface. Tower height from deck surface to top of tower is 109 meters. So total height of tower is 156 meters. MS steel used in tower is 25 mm thick. Diameter of main cable is 590 mm. Diameter of hanger ropes in main span is 57 mm and side span is 48 mm. Number of hanger ropes in each main span is 89 and in each side span is 39. RCC slab thickness is 225 mm and surfacing on dead is limiting to 38 mm. Go to File and click on New Model. Set default units to be kilonewton and meter. Click on Grid Only option. Defining number of grids, I will set grid spacing manually. Right click on Window Screen and click on Edit Grid Data. Click on Modify Show System. I have X grid spacing of 408 meter of side span, then 503 meter and 503 meter which is main span, then 408 meter other side span. I have Y grid spacing of 33 meter which is deck width. I have elevation level of 47 meter at deck and 156 meter at top of tower. I have not proper section property data of bridge structure, so I am just taking sections on assumption. Go to Define Section Properties and click on Frame Section. Click on Add New Property. Click on Steel Tube. I am defining 10 feet by 10 feet tube section with 1 inch thickness. I am defining cross bracing of tower size 8 feet wide and 3 feet depth with 1 inch thickness. I am defining steel beam of 3 feet by 6 feet tube section with 1 inch thickness. Click on Import New Property. Click on Steel Angle. Select AISC 14 and click OK. List of steel angle section opened which exist in AISC Steel Manual. Select Maximum Size Angle and click on OK. Change length unit to mm. Go to Define Section Properties and click on Area Sections. Click on Add New Section. I am defining 225 mm thick slab with FC prime equals to 6000 psi. Go to Define, Section Properties and click on Cable Sections. Click on Add New Section. I am defining main cable of suspension bridge having 590 mm diameter. Click on Add Copy of Section. I am defining main span hanger rope having 57 mm diameter. Click on Add Copy of Section. I am defining side span hanger rope having 48 mm diameter. Go to Define and click on Load Patterns. Dead load pattern is self weight of structure. Add live load and SDL, which is super dead load. Go to Draw and click on Draw Frame Cable Tendon. Modeling Tower Columns. Go to Draw and click on Draw Frame Cable Tendon. Select Main Cable. As you click second joint of cable, cable geometry data open. Select maximum vertical sag option from drop down list of cable type. I have maximum sag of 106.5 meter of main cable. Input number of line segments to be 90 because main span has 89 hanger ropes which will draw from main cable joints. Check option model cable using straight frame object. Also set option of break into multiple equal length objects. So suspension cable is now break into 90 frames having each frame of equal length. See suspended cable model with 90 equal length cables. Go to Draw and click on Draw Frame Cable Tendon. Select Steel Angle section. And model in main span. This main span will be truss system of angle. Go to Draw and click on Draw Frame Cable Tendon. Select main span hanger cable of 57 mm. Modeling main span hanger cables. As you click second joint of cable, cable geometry data open. Select cable type to undeformed length as this is a straight hanger cable with no sagging. Also check option model cable using straight frame object. Click on OK. Same as first hanger rope draw, other hanger ropes are joint of main cable draw as I am doing. There are 89 hanger ropes on main span of bridge at one side. After draw half side hanger ropes of main span, go to Select, Select, Properties and click on Cable Properties. Choose main span hanger cable of 57 mm diameter. Go to Edit and click on Replicate. Go to Mirror tab. Click on Pick two points on model and select points as I am doing to mirror from center line of bridge. And click on OK to replicate. See, all main span hanger ropes has been modeled. Go to Draw and click on Draw Frame Cable Tendon. Select Steel Beam. Side span has a steel beam unlike main span which is truss system. Model a steel beam on both side spans. Select End Joints of Side Span and Base Joint of Tower Columns. Go to Assign, Joint and click on Restraints. Click on Fixed Joint to assign. Go to Draw and click on Draw Frame Cable Tendon. Select Main Cable. As you click second joint of cable geometry data open. Select Maximum Vertical Sag option from drop down list of cable type. Input number of line segments to be 40 because side span has 39 hanger ropes which will draw from main cable joints. Check option model cable using straight frame object. Also set option of break into multiple equal length object. I have maximum sag of 20 meter of main cable. So suspended cable is now break into 40 frame having each frame of equal length. Select side span hanger cable of 48 mm dia. Modeling side span hanger cables. As you click second joint of cable geometry data open. Select cable type to undeformed length as this is a straight hanger cable with no sagging. Also check option model cable using straight frame object. Same as first hanger rope draw other hanger ropes at joint of main cable draw as I am doing. There are 39 hanger ropes on left side span of bridge at one side. After draw left side hanger ropes of side span, select steel beam of side span, go to view and click on show selection only. Again go to view and click on invert view selection to show all except steel beam. Select side span main cable and hanger ropes. Go to edit and click on replicate. Go to mirror tab. Click on pick two points on model and select points as I am doing to mirror from central line of bridge and click on OK to replicate. Select main span steel angle section with joints. Go to Edit, Edit Lines and click on Divide Frames. Choose option Break at intersection with selected joint straight frames. This main span steel angle break into frames between hanger ropes as showing on screen. Go to Select, Select, Properties and click on Frame Sections. Select only angle section L8x8x9x16. Go to Edit, Replicate. Input DZ value to -5 m. Angle section is now copy -5 m from deck level. Draw vertical and inclined truss member. Go to Select, Select, Properties and click on Frame Sections. Select only angle section L8x8x9x16. Go to View and click on Show Selection only. Select vertical and inclined truss member. Go to Edit and click on Replicate. Go to Mirror tab. Click on Pick two points on model and select points as I am doing to mirror from central line of bridge and click on OK to replicate. Select all. Go to Edit and click on Replicate. Input DY value to 33 m, which is deck width. See all frame and cable sections copy to other side of bridge. Go to elevation of tower. Go to draw and click on draw frame cable tendon. Select cross bracing to model between towers. After modeling of cross bracing, select cross bracing. Go to edit and click on replicate. Input dx value to 1006 meter, which is main span of bridge between two towers. Open plan of deck level of 47 meter. Go to draw and click on draw frame cable tendon. Select steel beam. Model in plan from joints of hanger ropes as I am doing. After model beam in side span, go to draw, draw rectangular area. Select 225 mm slab and model in plan at deck level. Similarly as previous, select steel beam and slab area of side span. Go to edit and click on replicate. Go to mirror tab. Click on pick two points on model and select points as I am doing to mirror from central line of bridge and click on OK to replicate. Similarly, model beam and slab area in main span of bridge. Select only steel beams, go to Assign, Frame and click on Release Partial Fixedity. Check Moment 22 and 33 start and end to release fixedity of beam from both joints. Go to Select, Properties and click on Area Sections. Select 225mm area. Go to Assign, Area Load and click on Uniform to Frame Shell. Input live load of 5 kN per meter square to apply load on full bridge deck area. Go to Select, Properties and click on Area Sections. Select 225mm area. Go to Assign, Area Load and click on Uniform to Frame Shell. Input SDL of 1 kN per meter square to apply load on full bridge deck area. Go to Display, Show Object Load Assigns and click on Area. Select Live. Choose option Uniform Load to Frame Resultant. Click on OK. See, load is automatically shifted to frame as I selected option Uniform to Frame during Assign Area Load. Go to Analyze and click on Run Analysis. Go to Display and click on Show Deform Shape. This is deformed shape of bridge under its own self weight. Go to Display, Show Force Stresses. Click on Frame Cable Tendons. Choose component axial force. Click on OK. This is axial force on frame and cable under dead load. See approximately 69,700 kN tension force in main cable of main span. Side span has more tension force than main span, approximately 70,800 kN. Tension force in main cable will be maximum near to tower support. Right click on hanger cable to show complete data of force, shear and moment values. See, this hanger rope has approximately 400 kN tension force. Go to display, show forces, stresses, click on frame cable tendons, select live load, choose component axial force. Click on OK. This is axial force on frame and cable under live load. Main span main cable has approximately 107,000 kN tension force. Right click on hanger rope. Approximately 870 kN tension force in hanger rope. Go to display, show forces, stresses, click on joints, select dead load, right click on joint, this is base joint reaction data. As I told you at starting, I will not use code data required for bridge design. This is just video showing to model suspension bridge in SAP 2000 and how its forces goes from deck to main cable through hanger ropes, then further proceed to foundation through tower. If you need any assistance in structural engineering or you want your structures to be designed, you can contact me through email address given. Do like, share and comment below in comment section. Also subscribe and press bell icon so that you will never miss any new video.